Chapter 2, Journey to the University. Makes kiting really easy too.
This is insane.
Jeez Louise. They just completely overran us.
Yeah, I think
we're pretty squished right now.
Yeah, it'd be nice to maybe get like another tank up front or nature mage to sustain us a bit more. That's what we back down. We're gonna jump down the depths here. See what we got. Holy crap, what? How much lumber is like involved in creating something like that? Jeez Louise. That's a lot of lumber. Like that must be super expensive just to create something like this. Like, and what is this for, even? Like, this room, is this just a barracks? No, I think there's more to it than that. Oh, and then there's just like a well underground here. Drink any of that water, that's just a lot of still water. Oof. That's it. Oh god. Like, look at that. I don't even think that's not even wood. That's just metal. In the world of magic, when you can, like, literally change just, like, farmer's tool into gold, I'm not gonna think too hard on that stuff, but it is just kind of interesting to put into some perspective there. It's like, that's pretty speculative.
Spiders.
I was gonna say, like, there were so many arrows I made.
Oh,
satisfying sound. Everyone's just, oh, that's kind of groovy, anyway. Yes, please. Alright, quick pause so we can actually take care of this without getting jumped. Alright, yeah. That's going on. Those are still the same. Where are we at strength wise? Still not enough for any of these fun ones, huh? There, anything there, right there, nope. Sure, bow, nope. A bunch of hacks still. Okay. Dexterity 12. Okay, yeah, we get one more dexterity and then we can do the heart stopper, which is 200. Nice. That'll be good. That's 100. That's decent. I don't know. That's decent. 204. But that's 12 to 15 to 19. So the minimum is higher. And we'll just hold the same strength. And we can't use any of them either. Right. Onward. Actually, new things. Idea. I'm just gonna use up a bunch of mana here so I can. I'm pretty cheap when it just comes to like mana usage. No level. There we go. Weird. Now we have room. A little bit of they're coming out of nowhere. That was a lot. That was just a lot right there. Yeah. Drink break. is going on up there? It's like a shooting like a fucking skull or something. He's got health potions, right? So I'm gonna charge him. Okay, there we go. Let's say like we're all full. Just gonna kind of drop some repeat items and not good items. Oh, dude, we've been using this for a while. Let's wipe that. It's a 10-13. Yeah, that could have been done for a while ago. Leather gloves, that's gotta go. Spiked mace versus this magic mace. Plus one, the melee skill. Is that gonna... Oh, that's gotta go too. Okay, these all unlock at the same time, so that's gonna go. These just stabs. Don't really help me out much. Big bow, 208. This is just going to be an insane job, but everything's just going to explode. Range damage reduce. So it's a 10-10, but like the difference is 2. We'll probably hold on to it so we can sell it. Feels a little better, right? So her gets, oh, she can't even use it yet. 208, 200. Oh, it's both dexterity. Okay, I think. Alright. So we'll watch a good explosion of items here. And go. I feel a lot lighter. History of the Drug. Biography of whom? Hudson has the distinction of having been declared dead more often than any other soldier in the history of the Temple Legion. What? He is said to be beaten by goblin raiders at Frostfire Pass in 965, only to turn in the battle into a bloody rout of the goblin forces 3 days later. Like, many years later, he was said to have died in a snowstorm while retrieving his beloved meal, Caprine, only to turn up a week later, hungry and irritated by a hole in his boot. This dude sounds like a cool dude. Alright. For his allies, the stories of his death are a source of frequent amusement. To his enemies, a wishful dream. He has said that death will only take him when he's gotten too bored or too tired of living. And even then, the Reaper had better bring heavy reinforcements. Born in the Aegalian Peaks in 944, and raised by a former cook of the 10th Legion, Ibsen headed west for the kingdom of Ebb as a courier for the Asunite Synod at the age of 16 in 961. Wait. So, at the age of 16... Okay. At the age of 16, period, in 961... I was gonna say he's 16 and 961. So, okay. Anyway, he arrived at the castle and presented a recommendation that he be assigned to his mother's post, but his cooking was found to be inferior to his soldiering, and he found himself very shortly thereafter in the command of his platoon. Alright, so he's a bad cook, but he's a better fighter. Makes sense. Let's see here. Assigned to maintaining order along the Fedwar's way during the affair of the Goblin Pretender, Ebsen met a brand of goblin soldiers besieging the Iron Tower of Glaciern, that's where we're headed right now, and beat them back, sending all but a few of his men to help in the defense of the mines. Days later, he defeated two full platoons attempting to pass Glaciern into the Eastern Kingdom. Formally resigning from military service in 94, he became the overseer of the Western Realm. Oh, is this the dude that we're meeting? Yeah, I think this is the dude that we're meeting. I think this is the dude that we're going to be meeting here. No, he's not, because it literally just said that he was retired. Yeah. He retired as... Right? Yeah. Formally resigning. Although retired, he's one of the most respected strategists of the Old Legion. Okay. Yeah. Ibsen, I think we're going to meet him. If not, that's a really cool story. It's a history of the Drog. This is the people that, person from stone, whatever, like, just swindled, basically. Late in the 6th century, an imperial trading company seeking alternative routes beyond the Green Range was startled to discover a large and thriving community living in the Cliffs of Fire. The exceptional weapons and jewelry possessed by these simple cliff dwellers. But the self-sufficient drog could see no reason why they could exchange any of their valuables for the unappealing trinkets. Okay, trading companies, kind of reinforcing what happened. Companies tried and failed to interest the drog. Instantly spellbound, with visions of gold in their eyes, the small caravan. Like what have it, the caravan was captured, and the goblins learned of the drog interest in the materials. These goblins are kind of menaces. Oh, yeah. Goblins never forgot Ethan Stonebridge, and many years later would return to the exact... Okay. Over the course of 6 months, I mean, the Legion bolts of cloth and tow. Freelancer trader. All right, that's interesting. Yeah, so... the drug definitely settled up with Stonebridge, and Ito was like, nope, go away. Annoying, gross goblins. Here, I'm actually gonna. Cool. Alright, some more lore. Oh, there's the Kuris Noani again. Shortage of farmers. I'm gonna hold on to this one because I think we might come close to something. Soul Lance. I want to take a peek at that spell. Twenty-four mana cost. I mean, it'll just straight up explode the target. Yeah, let's try that. Be kind of fun. Just explode some things. Okay, back to it. It's cool, but it sucks too much, man. Knobbed club. Oh, what? Okay, let's go. Now we're getting the cool spells. Okay. So let's say acquires combat magic 3. I think I got that. That's a bit of a battle. It's crazy just how like big of an explosion that is. Nice. A new chest. That's not good, is it? Oh, we got some Zark leather. Zerask. Which, I think we have some data on these folk. The Zerask. A race of Sururians. The Zeraks were coaxed out of the jungles and swamps. This is what they look like. There we go. Yeah. First obedient. Oh god, were they a slave race? Yeah, they were. Okay. Yep. Yep. Deep rooted hatred for the Ulterians. These folk. These were the Ulterians who were, I guess, were. Yeah, had those folks who worked for them. yeah, that's kind of unsettling, fun little lore. Yeah, so that's just your casual unsettling things in video games. All right. One shot at it with that spell, but still. Music though. Alright. Yeah, I don't know if that was the best decision. Thank you. there's something weird going on with that piece. I don't know. Hey, here we go. Power spike. Cider spike bomb. 208, what the heck? 12 meters, 12. Oh, okay. Well, still, though, that's... Why would you not use this one? I don't know. It feels kind of like a moot point in my mind. Still can't use it, huh? Or really anything yet. Okay. Well, we got a bit of a power spike with the hatchet. That's cool. 240. Yeah, I think this is gonna be the... Cool. Alright. One up so much just because I get to spend and all this.
Cheers.
Let's try with that. Let's try what that is. What? Acify? Oh, I think that's per, like, hit with, I think that's, like, if you hit someone with the staff, which isn't as impressive. Yeah, I think that's just like a weapon thing. But that feels nice. It's another power spike here going on. Just pick up whatever small potions you can get. No, we're not hitting this. Like the little gauntlet that just goes. All right. massive structure, but casually underground. So we were going to place into this massive. Okay, I think I remember now. Yeah, it's still good. Yes, I am going to grab every single gold. That's just what's gonna happen. If I miss any gold, you have to tell me, and I will go back. It's like little low level, like I think, yeah, I'm probably gonna drop those, but it's pretty cool. Winning strategy when you're in like big fights like this. Is it best to target like the most probable hitters? Or is it like, I guess it's all situation dependent, but is it better to hit the heaviest hitters, just get them out of the way, or clear out like the little weaky guys that just may not give you that much trouble? I mean, she's looking at me, she's covered. Come on, go. Run over from one area. Over to the next. Just getting up. This dude is just getting pummeled out here. Like, he has to keep walking from one direction to the other. Just getting stung with like acid spit and then like just getting smacked by these things. By the time you do get to them, they probably kind of take care of them, which is nice, but I think that's probably why he's not hitting as hard as he could. Feeling us to run all the way up. Shooting at him from a distance. Oh gosh. Yeah, I'd hate this thing. it's what's where you can kind of just like certainly unlock a certain amount of aggro. Like, if you play enough video games, you kind of know that if it's like a huge boss fight, you just kind of feel it. If we just kept running and then trying to take that here, that's pretty rough. Spike, please. In multiple ways. You can have this buckler now. At least for a little while here. Let's get this good leather. She can have some good leather here too then. Yeah, that's good. I'm not gonna be dying out here so quick either. Studded leather boots. Have your boots. There we go. Hey, that feels a lot better. Alright. Any other changes with DPS? Okay, that's a 14. Give me that. This is riveting gameplay, I can just tell. I can tell everyone's just loving this. You need to do this. This is something you need to do. Alright, no one's even gets up to it. Ugh, that's not even that good of a shield, man. No, what's like. Oh god. That's really not that good of a shield. I thought it was gonna be a lot better. Alright, are we anywhere close to this? Some Power Spike. Oh no, what the heck? No, you don't need that. But he might need this. 240, it's 240. 1921. I don't know, I think I'm gonna keep with the rusted spike mace. But my inventory is not full, and I would love to pick that up. I can cast it. How long do I have it? 360? Alright, yeah, let's try it. What the hell is that noise? Oh, I have enough for it. Maybe I just can't cast it until there's like someone nearby. That could be the case. Alright. That's pretty cool. Gold. I'm pretty sure the objective is that they just walk around and light all of the successfully do that. It's a weird noise. Okay. Let's try this area. We haven't found here yet. This isn't great gameplay though. That's what I'm saying, it would be really nice to kind of, in Dungeon Siege 2, what you could do is kind of like an auto-cast system, where if it's not active, it will just recast it for you. So I think it would be really nice if you were able to essentially So yeah, as I was saying, I think it'd be really nice to be able to just kind of like auto-cast my ball of fire, just that way I can just kind of have that on me constantly. And then from there I can kind of, or because it actually lets you do two of them. Dude. Oh. All right. So. Oops. Sometimes you just oopsie. Yeah, so like in Dungeon Siege 2, there was like, in this area, there was like a book where you could just go like... Chance to hit. Oh, cool. Anyway, it was like... a way for you to just kind of constantly have things like sent out, like for your summoning, you can constantly have like a summoned creature up, and then for a, I don't know, like healing spells and things like healing hands or healing wind, things like that, you can just kind of constantly have that up, which is nice. That's why I think it'd be really nice to have like a reinvested version of this, because I do think that I'm having a lot of fun with this game. Like, I'm having a lot of fun with it. I think it's, I don't know, it's a dungeon crawler. This is what you ask for. This is what you ask for. That's cool. What intelligence? Oh, damn. I was gonna say, I think that'd be kind of cool if I'm somehow able to get Laura to have that. So just like have a free plus one to range. Oh, jeez. Oh, right. That was just a little side quest, was it not?